These may be challenging times for the Reinford Company, but it is just as much a new beginning. I'm expecting rapid growth from you, leading the 4th Development Division. Show me that I was right to place my faith in your talents as our daughter. Have I made myself clear?
Ah, I'm so glad that you were able to make it here.
Whoa! Isn't that... Father?
I apologize if my appearance startled you. This is only a recording, I'm afraid. One I pieced together before Alberic, when I was still myself. I'm afraid I might end up rambling from time to time as a result, but you'll have to forgive me.
Oh.
It's like that projection technology that Teo once used.
I presume you being here means that you are fully back to normal, Milliam. What a relief that is. Now that you and Altina are freed from the Twilight's burden, you can finally live the lives you deserved all along. You can now grow as human beings, completely free of the limitations you were subject to before. I hope you will take this chance to learn, love, and experience all the world has to offer now that your lives are your own.
They really are ours now.
We always thought it was weird how we never got much taller, but maybe that's a thing of the past now. I hope you're ready for my insanely huge boobies uses, because they're gonna be busting!
If only you were half as much concerned with your mental maturity as you were with your physical.
I apologize for never becoming a first disciple worthy of you, Professor Schmidt. I'd hoped to leave you a better capstone project before moving on to my own, and to this day, I regret that I could not. But I have no doubt your other disciples, Makarov, George, Tita, will go on to circle laps around my accomplishments. I hope you'll support the next generation, as well as continue being the pinnacle of excellence they should strive to follow. May you live only the longest and happiest of lives.
I have my doubts as to whether they'll ever equal you, never mind surpass you. But you always were a dreamer.
I'm with the professor on this one. That won't stop me from trying. Last thing I want is for my own laziness to prevent me from standing tall with the rest of us engineers.
To Elisa, I'm so sorry again for what I've put you through. My actions have forced you to endure losing your father not once, but twice. But you have grown so much, and I know you have the strength to overcome that loss. May your life be brimming with joy. Joy shared by your mother, grandfather, Sharon, and everyone who loves you. Your happiness matters to me more than anything else in this world.
Father, I'll be okay. Just knowing that you are thinking of me this much is enough.
What did I tell you? There I go with my rambling. Now, before we part, I'd like to share a lesson I learned too late. When technology's architects leave this world, they do not get to take their creations with them. They cannot control who succeeds them, nor can their noble intentions prevent others from using their works for ill. Still, just as you overcame the Twilight, so too will you overcome any and all obstacles that might come your way. To all who hear these words, I leave my loved ones, the Empire, and the future in your capable hands.
Father.
He's gone.
Quite the Herculean task to leave us with.
Perhaps it's the duty that falls on those of us fortunate enough to live on.
I suppose you're right. Thank you, everyone. I'm so glad I was able to come here and see Father one last time.
As am I.
And I'm super glad I've got Lammy back! Thanks for helping me out, guys. That means you too, Nammy. Our work is done then.